never set the tone on how his dealers operate, Dan Rooney said of his father. He has always said that what the people think is important and that what we have to think that, and we have to think that way. He very much felt that everyone was his equal. You must treat people with respect. The Pittsburgh Steelers are one of the longest-lasting football teams in the league. That was founded by a current legend and started to find its success during the 70s, and then again in the new millennium. I picked this topic to share with you because I have been a Steelers fan ever since I was little, and most people that watch football today only know them from what their quarterback Big Ben was accused of. There is much more to the Steelers' rich history than what people know, and I hope to show you that the Steelers are a successful and also respectable franchise. Arthur Rooney Sr. is who founded Pittsburgh football. After winning $250,000 in horse racing, he invested money into creating the team in 1932. Without Art Rooney, the Steelers wouldn't be where they are today, or even a team at all. Art originally named the team the Pittsburgh Pirates, but after numerous losing seasons, renamed the team the Steelers. The name Steelers was a better fit for Pittsburgh and was a name more closely linked with the blue-collar city. In 1943, the Steelers merged with the Eagles because of a lack of players during World War II to be named the Steagles. The next year, the Steelers combined with the Cardinals to be called Card Pitt. The Steelers and Art Rooney did not find much success over the next few decades, but were not far away from turning things around. Art was doing everything he could to make his team successful. He always had good things to say, encouraging words, and a pat on the back. Steelers Hall of Fame running back Frank O'Hare said of Rooney, "It was really wonderful because leadership is everything. You can tell an organization by how the people conduct themselves at the top." After decades of not finding success, the Steelers were about to turn things around in the 70s. With new coach Chuck Knoll, the Steelers were close to their first championship. The Steelers acquired many future Hall of Fame players in the 70s, which helped lead them to their first championship in the 1974 season. After their first Super Bowl win, their success took off. The Steelers ended up winning 4 Super Bowls in the next 6 years, and they were the team of the decade. However, after the 4th Super Bowl win, Chuck Knoll retired, and players were getting worn down. In that respect, Super Bowl 14 was the end of a dynasty. Another 25 years passed without a Super Bowl win, although they made it there once in the early 90s, only to lose to the Cowboys. The Steelers would hopefully start a new dynasty in the 2005 season led by head coach Bill Cowher, as they would win their 5th Super Bowl in team history. Unlike in the 70s, when the dynasty ended after a coaching change, Pittsburgh stayed competitive after Bill Cowher left, after staying with the team for 15 years, filling in for Hall of Fame coach Chuck Knoll. Cowher had led the team to 2 Super Bowl appearances, 6 AFC championship games, and 10 postseason appearances. The Steelers tied the record for the most division titles and the NFL's best overall record during Bill Cowher's tenure. There were big shoes to fill once Cowher left, but the next and current coach, Mike Tomlin, was up for the challenge. Mike Tomlin and the Steelers found early success. With Ben Roethlisberger and Hines Ward on offense, and James Harrison and Troy Polamalu on defense, it wasn't hard for Mike Tomlin to make an early success with his career. In his first year as head coach, he led his team to the playoffs, but they came up short. He was also the first coach to win division titles in his first 2 seasons. The Steelers would win a record-breaking 6th Super Bowl against the Cardinals in the 2008 season. Mike Tomlin was the youngest coach to lead a team to the Super Bowl and the 3rd African American to coach a team in the Super Bowl. After winning 2 Super Bowls in 4 years, the Steelers recently came up short after trying to win their 7th in team history against the Green Bay Packers. The Steelers are a competitive team and will not let the loss put them down. The Steelers are one of the longest-lasting football teams in the NFL. That was founded by a current legend and started to find success in the 70s and then again in the new millennium. They currently hold the record for most Super Bowl wins in NFL history. They also have 19 players in the Hall of Fame, which include 9 from the 70s dynasty. The Steelers have been a very successful and respectable team in the NFL.